The Lord be with you and a warm welcome to you as always from all of us here at Powers Court with Kilbride. Continue our journey through the letter of James. Divine wisdom is gentle and kind and peaceful. That's easier said than done. The question for this morning is, what can we do to establish within ourselves that rock that Jesus talks about to build our house upon? That knowledge that can change things for us so that we begin to operate from a place of wisdom such as this. But first, we pause for a moment to acknowledge the presence of Christ with us wherever we are this day, to say thank you to God for Christ's presence, his eternal presence with us. And so we draw breath. We bring to God all that lies upon our hearts this day. We draw to mind the baggage we may carry, the regrets we may hold. We ask for his forgiveness, for his healing power, in order to redeem us and to guide us on from this moment into the rest of our lives.
The epistle reading is taken from James 3. At the heart of this reading on true and false wisdom stands the conviction and confession that wisdom is a sign of the Spirit's indwelling presence and a confirmation of the ongoing grace of God that is at work in those who seek to be faithful in the exercise of pure religion. Who is wise and understanding among you? Show by your good life that your works are done with gentleness, born of wisdom. But if you have bitter envy and selfish ambition in your hearts, do not be boastful and false to the truth. Such wisdom does not come down from above, but is earthly, unspiritual, devilish. For where there is envy and selfish ambition, there will also be disorder and wickedness of every kind. But the wisdom from above is first pure, then peaceable, gentle, willing to yield, full of mercy and good fruits, without a trace of partiality or hypocrisy. And a harvest of righteousness is sown in peace for those who make peace. Those conflicts and disputes among you, where do they come from? Do they not come from your cravings that are at war within you? You want something and do not have it, so you commit murder. And you covet something and cannot obtain it, so you engage in disputes and conflicts. You do not have because you do not ask. You ask and do not receive because you ask wrongly in order to spend what you get on your pleasures. Submit yourselves therefore to God. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. Draw near to God and he will draw near to you. Cleanse your hearts, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. Here ends the lesson.
Good morning. Our gospel reading for today is from Mark chapter 9, verses 30 to 37. They went on from there and passed through Galilee. He did not want anyone to know it, for he was teaching his disciples, saying to them, "The Son of Man is to be betrayed into human hands, and they will kill him. And 3 days after being killed, he will rise again." But they did not understand what he was saying and were afraid to ask him. Then they came to Capernaum. And when he was in the house, he asked them, "What were you arguing about on the way?" But they were silent, for on the way they had argued with one another about who was the greatest. He sat down, called the 12, and said to them, "Whoever wants to be first must be last of all and servant of all." Then he took a little child and put it among them, and taking it in his arms, he said to them, "Whoever welcomes one such child in my name welcomes me. And whoever welcomes me welcomes not me, but the one who sent me." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
God asks us to be a certain way in this world. He asks us to be humble, as we have heard over the past couple of weeks, to be gentle, to be peaceful, to be thoughtful before we speak, to be careful. Once we begin to turn in on ourselves, to be ambitious within ourselves for the good of us rather than good of everyone else, once things begin to change like this in us, we're the house that's built on sand. And believe me, the sands of the world are continuously shifting. And as a result, we'll be tossed around like a wave of the sea. If we don't establish ourselves first on the rock and the strong foundation, that is Christ Himself. A lot of our turmoil within ourselves comes from just there, within ourselves, and God is always willing to help us. But interestingly, this morning, the writer of James tells us that we ask and we don't receive because we're not asking in the right way. I wonder how many of us truly believe that God will give us what we ask. For starters, we need the faith that this is actually going to happen, even though the result of our asking may not look anything like what we expect. The second thing to note about the letter to James this morning, that passage, is that we are asking only for the good of ourselves at times, and the response to this will not come. But if our intentions are more mature, wiser, more outreaching, more generous, more in unity with the rest of the world, then marvellous things can be achieved and prayers can most definitely be answered. But in order for all of this to happen, something has to change on the inside of ourselves. This is something that we have been working on and talking about in different shapes and forms throughout the past year and a half together here in this square. The something that needs to happen is metanoia. It's a change of heart, a change of mind. And this can easily come about if you allow yourself to accept that the creator of all that is yours and has made you and loves you and accepts you and calls you forward, that you are his child. The change in attitude and the prolific change in attitude that can occur is when we allow ourselves to recognize that we are children of God. If you are able to free yourself from the bonds of this world for just a moment in order to fully recognize within your soul that you are a child of God, that the Father and the Son live within you, then that's the starting place for great change and transformation. When you waken in the morning, remember whose child you are and straighten your crown.